For understanding what is a chopper socket, we need to first understand what is a freewheeling diode. It is also called as a flywheel. To understand this diode, we will first consider a circuit which has got a DC supply voltage Vs, with negative here, positive here. This supply is given to a switch here, which is right now open. Then it is given to a diode D and given to a load which consists of resistor and inductor L. So your load has resistive as well as inductive part. Your load is RL load. Now see carefully what happens in this circuit. When this switch is closed, let us see what happens. When switch S is closed, the supply is connected to the switch, then to the diode, resistor, inductor, this RL load, and the circuit is completed. So when switch S is closed, there will be a current flowing through this circuit with this path. Let's call this current as I. Diode is forward biased because you have positive terminal connected to the anode, so the diode is forward biased. This current will flow through the load, and this current is gradually increasing through the inductor. Whenever you have inductor connected in the load part, the load current will start slowly increasing. Also, it is called as gradually increasing load current. Now, because of this gradually increasing load current, there will be some energy stored in this inductor. Now, let us see what happens when the switch is opened. Switch S is now opened. Let us see how your circuit looks like. This is how your circuit will now look like with source voltage here Vs, switch S is now opened, diode and the RL load. Now in this case, when switch was closed, load current I was gradually increasing and there was some energy stored here in the inductor. When the switch is closed, this energy stored in the inductor in the previous case, now that energy will now appear across the switch when the switch is opened, and that is how when the switch is opened, there will be a spark generated here across the switch which can damage the components present in the circuit. So, in order to avoid that happening, what we do is a diode is connected here with cathode here and anode here. There is a diode connected here, and this diode is called as a freewheeling diode FD. Let us just check again what is happening. First, we have taken this circuit. Then we have closed this switch. After closing the switch, diode is forward biased, so your current starts flowing through this circuit path. And because you have an inductor connected here in the load, you have your load current gradually or slowly increasing through the inductor, and there is a energy stored here in the inductor. After that, what we have seen is that with the switch S opened, the energy stored in the inductor comes across this switch, that is, the energy is dissipated across this switch, and there is spark taking place in the circuit, thereby damaging the circuit components. So in order to avoid that, we have connected a freewheeling diode here. So when there is freewheeling diode not present here, that is in this case, when the freewheeling diode is not present here and the current is flowing, your diode will be reverse biased. Because here you have your cathode, and to the cathode you will get positive supply, so it will be reverse biased. So this is opened. So the voltage that is appearing across these two terminals, that is across this diode, will be your output voltage, that is voltage across the load, and that voltage is supply voltage Vs. So when the switch is closed, FD gets reverse biased, and voltage, output voltage is equal to the supply voltage Vs. Whereas when the switch S is opened, what happens is the energy stored here, what it does is when the switch S is opened, what happens is This current, which had formed earlier in the circuit, now it starts gradually decreasing. This current I now starts slowly decreasing. Now, because it is slowly decreasing, what this current does is it induces a voltage across this inductor, which is given as VL is equal to L into di by dt. That is, this voltage, induced voltage, is inductor value multiplied by the rate at which load current is decreasing with respect to time. So this voltage is induced across the inductor. This voltage will now forward bias the diode, and because it is forward biased, it will now provide a shot here. Because of this shot, this current I will now complete its path like this. Because there is a shot here, the V naught, that is your